Hello dear students, welcome to Bosco Campus Vision YouTube channel of Kottayam Don Bosco College. I am Rania, faculty member of PG Department of English. In this series, we are discussing communicative applications. This is an open course for 5th semester UG students. So in this class also, we are discussing two major applications in communications. The first one is group discussion and the second one is speech. So let's begin our class. The first one is group discussion. So what do you mean by this group discussion? So I have already mentioned in this particular series, this series actually equipped you to perform very well in your career. Okay, so in this class we are discussing group discussion. When you go for a job interview, in some of the companies they demand to conduct group discussion. So what is group discussion? What is its purpose? Group discussion is actually, it is a methodology used by different organizations. Sometimes in educational institutions also conduct this group discussion. So some institutions conduct this group discussions, that may be educational institutions or any kind of business schools. So what is its purpose? Say they want to check your interpersonal communication level, your personality. So, how well you performed in a public speech. So, your personality, they want to check your personality traits like public speaking skill, then team spirit, leadership abilities, social behavior, and also problem solving skills. So, actually, this group discussion, it is conducted to gauge whether the candidate possesses certain personality traits. Whether you possess certain personality traits, whether you have the personality traits like interpersonal communication skills or leadership qualities and also the public speaking ability, etc., etc. So in order to check all these personality traits, they conduct group discussion. And one more important thing is this group discussions form an important part of the short listening process for recruitment or admission in a company or institution. So as I mentioned earlier, sometimes educational institutions also conduct group discussion. So they want to check your skills. They want to check your skills whether you are suitable for that particular course. So in order to do that, they used to conduct group discussions. The next one is how to conduct a group discussion. So when you conduct a group discussion, minimum 7 participants is needed for that. So there are usually 7 to 12 participants in a group when you conduct a group discussion. And the group of candidates is given a topic or a situation which could be either factual, abstract or case-based, and give some time to think and make notes about it. So how does that process happen? As I mentioned, 7 to 12 individuals are needed for a group discussion. So initially, the firm or the educational institutions give a topic. So based on the topic, they also give some time to think about the topic, to discuss within the group. So this is the normal process. This is the normal process which is used in conduction of a group discussion. Then after this, the group of candidates are asked to discuss it, the topic among themselves, and for a specific duration ranging from 10 to 40 minutes. So after thinking, the group members are asked to interact in between the group regarding the topic they are given. So while the group discuss the pertaining issue at hand, the moderators or panelists silently observe each candidate on various predetermined parameters. So when the group discussion is going on at that time, the panelists may judge you on the basis of certain predetermined parameters. So it is based on that parameters they are giving marks or values to the group members of the group. And the panelist assigns scores to every candidate based on his or her individual performance as well as how he performed within the group. Sometimes we think that it is a group discussion, so we don't want to speak anything. Only the group discussion, the points of the group discussion will get on based on the points given by the group members. No, so in group discussion, the panelist will definitely check each of the group members in the group. So on the basis of his performance, mark is given. Okay, so I hope you understood how to conduct a group discussion. So in this series, I'm giving one of the examples for a group discussion. And here I'm giving the topic is women are more mature than men in taking decision. So that is the topic. So usually when you write a group discussion for your university examination, the question will definitely ask to write a group discussion. So when you write a group discussion, you must write first, you write mention the heading. Then after that, you must write the introduction. So based on the topic given, you just give the introduction. Usually when in the group discussion, one of the group members or moderators will introduce the subject, and after that the group discussion will begin. So you definitely you should write the introduction. So here in the given group discussion, on basis of the topic, I gave the statements for and against that topic. So first I listed the opinions of various students for the topic and later against the topic. So at the end of the group discussion, you must give the conclusion. Usually moderators are giving the conclusion for the group discussion. So this is the process, this is the way in which we write a group discussion. So please go through this sample given in this particular video class. The topic is women are more mature than men in taking decisions. So introduction is given, then some of the statements, four statements given by Anju, Manju, Chinju, Veena, Tara, Deepthi. So they are in the support of this statement, and some Deepu, Vishnu and Mahesh, they are against the topic. So and after that, at the end of it, a conclusion is also given. Please go through it, and don't forget to do the assignment at the end of this video lecture. So moving on to the next topic. The next topic is short speeches. Okay, so like group discussion, in short speeches also, they are actually assessing your personality skills, your communication skills. So this communication skills play a big role in our career. So preparing ourselves to make 1 or 2 minute speech helps us to fine tune our communication skills. This it also improves our clarity in oral communication by helping us to think spontaneously on our feet, to gather enough ideas on a given topic, and to put our ideas together in a logical and systematic order. So why should we conduct a speech? Sometimes it is quite common that, for example, suppose you imagine that tomorrow you will have a presentation at your college. So definitely you will prepare yourself in front of a mirror. That's quite common. So why should you do that? So in order to make practice. So practice definitely makes a man perfect. So By doing so, in preparing in front of a mirror, you correct yourself. You get the opportunity to correct yourself. So likewise, this speeches improves our clarity in oral communication by helping us to think spontaneously on our feet. Sometimes extempo competitions are there. So the topic is given 2 or 3 minutes before the performance. So at that time, what do you do? It helps you to think spontaneously on your feet and to gather enough ideas on the given topic. Then practicing short speeches help you in your presentation also. Okay, now let's think, what are the different stages of a speech? First one is identifying the topic or subject. Usually if it is for a competition, topic is given. Okay, the other thing is, suppose somebody says that tomorrow you should do a speech on the topic whichever whatever you like. So at that time you can select your topic. When you select your topic, it must be relevant. Okay, so then only the audience will be interested to you. So first stage is identifying the topic or subject. Second one is determining the purpose. So what is the purpose of your speech? There are four general purpose of speech. They are impress, inform, inspire and entertain. First one is impress. Through your speech, you must have the ability to impress your audience. So select your topic on the basis of that, impress. Second one is inform. Your speech definitely will have certain information. It must impress the audience. So it must inform the audience. So give certain knowledge to the audience. Then inspire. Your speech must be inspiring. Okay. So when you give a speech on the topic of social, the need of social service, your speech must have the ability to inspire others. Okay. Then the last one is entertain. Don't give a speech that is boring. Sometimes you can use some comical elements. So your speech must be entertaining. So all these four are the different general purpose of speech. So the second stage is determining the purpose. Third stage is gathering relevant information. Okay, so suppose your topic is given, sorry, you got the topic and you must, in order to present a good speech, you must gather, you must collect information that supports the given subject. Next stage is outlining information. So after collecting the information, so you maybe you get some information from library, from Wikipedia, from other sources, periodicals, etc. After collecting that, you must put it in the logical order. So outline the information. Next stage is prepare the speech. In front of the mirror, you can prepare yourself. So prepare the speech. Then final stage is presentation. Okay, dear students, please go through the sample speech given in this video lecture. Here I am giving a model speech by Dr. Juliet Fleischl on the importance of blood donation day. Okay, so here normally a speech starts with an address. You must write the address and after that you must wish them. For first one here it is, distinguished guests and colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, good morning to all. So after that you must write the content. Please write the content in paragraph. When you write, write it in the way general to particular. So when you begin your speech, you must impress the audience. You must call the attention of the audience. So in such a way that you must write the speech. Then at the end of the speech, you must write the word of thanks. Okay. So here the speech is end like this. So we hope that somebody love can collect above 90% or even 100% of blood supplies from voluntary unpaid donors. Thank you. So you must end the speech by a word of thanks. Okay, my dear students. So let's conclude today. Please do the homework and send me back through WhatsApp. Thank you. Have a nice time.